everyone, and welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. My name is Francesco Alessio, and welcome back to another video. So in today's video, we are diving into the top 5 Android alternatives for to-do list applications. So of course, many of you know the popular applications like Todoist, To-Do, Microsoft To-Do, and even Wunderlist, and many more of them are available on Android. But sometimes when you're looking for a to-do list application, you want to look outside and make sure that your needs map to those platforms. So in today's video, I wanted to show you 5 of them that I think you would enjoy, ones that you may not have heard of before, and a few that ring a bell too. So just before we dive in, guys, a big thank you to Monday.com, who is sponsoring this full week here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. A big thank you to them. They are a project management software that teams use to get things done. I've done a full 30-minute review. You can get 8% off yearly accounts in the description below. But a big thank you to Monday.com for jumping in this week as the sponsor. So let's kick off with the first application, which is AnyDo. Now I know a lot of you guys know AnyDo from iOS as well as web. They have a pretty cross-platform experience, but AnyDo allows you to organize tasks into lists. You can share those lists with other people, so it's a very easy to share application in terms of being able to set that up. You can plot tasks out on a calendar, and you have a reminders function too. Now, AnyDo does have a few features hidden up its sleeve, like plan your day, allowing you to streamline the activities that you got by scheduling them ready for the day ahead. There are many different features inside of AnyDo, as well as an assistant, which is aiming to reduce the amount of workload that you have. And that's something that they're continually working on. Now, again, AnyDo has, I think, around 20 million downloads all across its devices, which is pretty impressive. And it's definitely an alternative to some of the big ones. And it's definitely, I would say, slipping into the big categories. Now it's available on so many different platforms. Now, AnyDo has a solid 4.5 rating on Android and has a really smooth application. So number 2 is Accomplish. Now, Accomplish is a task and calendar management experience. It is really simple in its structure. So you get this calendar view straight away and you can start importing tasks to this calendar. So if you're someone that likes calendar view task experiences, this might be great for you. So you can sync it with the likes of Google Calendar, and once you have a task on that left-hand side, on the list view, you can then drag it into your calendar view. So the gestures are great, and they seem to work really fluidly. So Accomplish is only available on Android, but it's got a solid 4.4 rating on the Google Play Store. So number 3 is Memorigi, if I pronounce that right. Now, Memorigi is an application that allows you to do a lot more than just manage tasks. It has a very nice view. So when you land on the application, you can select one of your viewing options to add a different task to, or even just start tallying a checklist. Now, they have some pre-created projects, or areas as they call them, and you can have things like ideas and activities, as well as life goals and habits. So it's quite a positive place as you get started, and there's not really too much work to do if you want to have a basic setup. Now, what's really nice about Memorigi is that you can view it from lots of different sort of viewing angles. You've got a simple card view, you've got a board view, and you can also add in boards, almost like these board areas, to your different sections. So what's great is you could view, like, for example, like ideas with life goals, and you can see that viewing options really easily. So it's got loads of great custom views, as well as a way to sort it in a simple fashion. Now, of course, you can store using the information, so you can add notes to your tasks inside of each of the areas. So you've got a secure place to store that. The application is from a developer called Timbit, who is based in Costa Rica, and it's got a solid 4.3 on the App Store. Now, I can't seem to find Memorigi on the iOS experience, but it's definitely an application that looks and works great on Android. So number 4 is Chaos Control. Now, this is an application I've actually chatted about before here on the channel, and it focuses a lot more on GTD, as well as a fixed structured process for your productivity. Now, Chaos Control is available on lots of different platforms, so you won't just find it on Android. You'll find it on iOS, I believe, as well as web, and for the desktop too, which is really awesome. Now, Chaos Control goes through a nice process, allowing you to have different inboxes, projects, labels, and all of the good stuff that comes along with GTD. Now, the application, I would say, positions itself as more of a to-do alternative, and the experience on the mobile versions has upgraded a lot since I last checked it out. Now, on Android, the actual application has a 4.1 rating, which is really positive. So this fifth and final application, Tasks, which is developed by an independent developer called Stephen Nottage, is an application that's got a really strong rating on the Android Play Store. It's got a 4.7, which is really high, and is very famed for a lot of its simplistic use. So inside of the application, you can just add checklists, get a task going, and you can add details to the task too. But that's really it. If you're looking for something that works really smoothly in terms of like a grocery list or something like that, like some very basic checklists, and you want themes, so the ability to style an application based on color, then this is the application for you. Now, a lot of people like this one. It's got a great rating, not some amazing design, but it just works really well, sort of material designy too. So they were the top five alternatives for to-do list applications. It's definitely worth checking them out. I've added the download buttons in the description for Android, so you guys can go away and check those out. Just before we leave, there are a few notable mentions, some specific ones that caught my attention on Android. Again, as I said, I'll be doing loads more Android features soon, so do stay tuned. So there is a Habitica alternative, which is called Quidu. So the application is available on iOS. It's available on Android as well, of course. And the application is priced on Android at £1.09, which is, I don't know what the US price is, but I'll include it below. And the iOS version is priced at $1.09. So Quidu does very well at allowing you to set these sort of achievements and be able to complete them using your character in the game. It's kind of sort of gamifying your productivity, but for many people, that sort of stuff works. So the final application is called Focus To Do. It's a Pomodoro timer with being a task manager as well. I was very impressed with this application. It allows you to create projects and you can create tasks in that project. And of course, the Pomodoro timer sets them off, and you can obviously assign per Pomodoro timer for each one. So for example, you have a task with 3 Pomodoro timers for the 3 cycles that you go around. Now, it's very easy to use, and what I quite like about it is there's a pinned area in the notification center, which essentially allows you to start a timer at any given point. Now, the application's available on all devices, I believe, and it's 4.4 rating on the Google. So guys, those were some of the Android applications. Let me know in the comments below what you thought of them, whether you're using any of them, because it'd be great to hear. Of course, these are alternatives, so they're not the top dogs and they'll be progressing and improving. But I would love to hear in the comments below if you'd like me to cover any specific Android categories. I'm about to go away on vacation, so I'd love to come back to some recommendations for Android applications to explore. Anyway guys, thank you so much for stopping by today. A big thank you to Monday.com for sponsoring this week here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Thank you very much guys. I really hope you're all doing very well. I'm probably on vacation right now, but I will see you guys very soon anyway. Thank you very much guys. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very soon. Cheers.